So we got NF Hope. I've already got the lyrics pulled up. Let's go ahead and check this out, y'all.
I'm on my way, I'm coming. Don't lose faith in me. I know you've been waiting. I know you've been praying for my soul. You've been dragging your feet, telling me I'm the reason we're stagnant. 30 years you've been claiming your honesty and promising progress. Well, where's it at? I don't want you to feel like a failure. I know this hurts, but I gave you your chance to deliver. Now it's my turn. Don't get me wrong. Nature had a great run, but it's time to give the people something different. So without further ado, I
am loving the atmosphere he's creating right here. You know what I'm saying? Like, this is something different. All right, I'm loving it.
Like to introduce my album. Hope. What's my definition of success? Listening to what your heart says. Standing up for what you know is right while everybody else is tucking their toe between their legs. What's my definition of success? Creating something no one else can. Being brave enough to dream big. Grinding when you're told to just quit. Giving more when you got nothing left. It's a person that'll take a chance on something they were told could never happen. It's a person that can see the bright side through the dark times when there ain't one. It's when someone who ain't never had.
I love that line right there, y'all. Yeah, we are definitely going to have to start doing an NF, y'all. I've been meaning to for a long time. I've just been preoccupied with doing other stuff. You know what I'm saying? We definitely gotta fix that.
Had nothing and afraid to walk away from more profit because they'd rather do something that they really love and take the pay cut. It's a person that would never waver or change who they are just to try and gain some credibility so they can feel accepted by a stranger. It's a person that can take the failures in their life and turn them into motivation. It's believing in yourself when no one else does. It's amazing what a little bit of faith can do. If you don't even believe in you, why would you think or expect anybody else that's around you to? I done did things that I regret. I done said things I can't take back. Was a lost soul at a crossroad who had no hope, but I changed that. I spent years of my life holding on to things I never should have kept, full of hatred. Years of my life carrying.
This is crazy. Okay. Look, usually, especially in like a rap song or something like that, you don't have a beat that will slow down to the point where it's almost nothing and then it slowly starts to build back up again, right? And he's doing that throughout the whole song. And it is kind of like building the suspense, right? Building the atmosphere. I mean, it is incredible, all right? I'm still going to go through and read the lyrics and break down the song, all right? But, man, like, what a performance this is.
A lot of baggage that I should have walked away from. Years of my life wishing I was someone different, looking for some validation. Years of my life trying to fill a void, pretending I was in. They get it.
Hey, what the heck just happened? They pushed you down. Don't let that throw you off, man. Don't. See, you were on a roll, you were going, you were pushing through obstacles, and they just pushed you down. Don't let that stop you. That's a them problem. That's not a you problem. haters gonna be. You know what I'm saying?
Evil, difficult to go through, yes, but beneficial. Some would say having a mental breakdown is a negative thing, which on one hand I agree, but on the other hand it was the push I needed to get help and start the healing process. See, if I'd never hit rock bottom, would I be the person that I am today? I don't believe so. I'm a prime example of what happens when you choose to not accept defeat and face your demons. Took me 30 years to realize that if you want to get the opportunity to be the greatest version of yourself, sometimes you gotta be someone you're not to hear the voice of reason. Having kids will make you really take a step back and look in the mirror. At least for me, that's what it did.
What happened now?
Wake up every day and pick my son up, hold him in my arms and let him know he's loved. Love. Standing by the window questioning if that is ever going to show up. Up isn't something he's going.
I think what's happening here is that he's not in charge of his own destiny, right? Like, he's trying, but people keep getting in the way. They're pushing him down, they're kidnapping him, they're bringing him to a bunch of weird places, and he's not in control. Alright, that's what I'm getting out of the video.
What to worry about, don't get it twisted, that was in a shot. Mama, I forgive you, I just don't want him to grow up thinking that he'll never be enough. 30 years of running, 30 years of searching, 30 years of hurting, 30 years of pain, 30 years of fearful, 30 years of anger, 30 years of empty, 30 years of shame, 30 years of broken, 30 years of anguish, 30 years of hopeless, 30 years of hey, 30 years of never, 30 years of maybe, 30 years of later, 30 years of fate, 30 years of hollow, 30 years of sorrow, 30 years of darkness, 30 years of hate, 30 years of baggage, 30 years of sadness, 30 years of stagnant, 30 years of change, 30 years of patience, 30 years of suffering, 30 years of 30 years of pain, 30 years of bitter, 30 years of lonely, 30 years of pushing everyone away. You'll never revolve. I know I can change. We are not enough. We are not the same. You don't have the heart. You don't have the strength. You don't have the will. You don't have the faith. You'll never be loved. You'll never be saved. Might as well give up. Not running away. You don't have the gun. You're the one afraid. I'm the one in charge. I'm taking the hook. I'm taking the
reins.
I'm taking the reins. I'm taking control over my own destiny. All right. That's exactly what I was talking about. They kept getting in his way, pushing him down, kidnapping him, throwing him off his game. You can't let him do that. All right. Let's go ahead and check out these lyrics now, y'all. It says Hope Lyrics Part 1. I wonder if there's going to be a Part 2 or 3 or whatever else. I don't know. Let's see. So he says, Hope. Yeah, I'm on my way. I'm coming. Don't lose faith in me. I know you've been waiting. I know you've been praying for my soul. Hope, 30 years you've been dragging your feet, telling me I'm the reason you're stagnant. So someone told him that he's dragging his feet and he's the reason why they're not getting ahead in life? Is that what's going on here? 30 years you've been claiming you're honest and promising progress. Well, where it at? I don't want you to feel like a failure. I know this hurts, but I gave you your chance to deliver. Now it's my turn. Don't get me wrong, Nate, you've had a great run, but it's time to give the people something different. Now, I'm sure, like, there's a lot of references in here to his previous songs that I'm not gonna get, alright? Matter of fact, let me check the annotation real quick. We'll see what that says for this segment. This segment seems to be written from his Hope's perspective, who reflects on Nathan's former, more pessimistic approach to life. He presented it in a lot of his lyrics up to The Search, which marked a turning point as it described his desire to seek change. It seems The Search has been proving successful, in the main narrative. His music has shifted. This is also emphasized by the imagery of the music video, and it appears in two contrasting outfits, the dark representing his old and the bright one his new self. So that helps to put that into perspective, so I understand what he's trying to say better. You know what I'm saying? So, and that fits with the overall video, right? The pessimists are trying to drag him down and say, well, you're changing and we don't like that. We need you to be, just like us, right? And they're trying to control his journey, right? But then, that's kind of ignoring the fact that he's a human being. He has the right to change. All right? We are not robots. We can learn and we can grow. And, we can grow and we can learn from our mistakes. We can make changes to better our lives, to better other people's lives. All right? And we shouldn't ever try and villainize people for wanting to change their lifestyle and be a better person. All right. What's my definition of success? Listening to what your heart says. Okay. Standing up for what you know is right. Creating something no one else can. So, in other words, he's saying he is successful because he's thinking out of the box. He's doing things differently than what everyone else is doing. All right. Being brave enough to dream big. Giving more when you've got nothing left. This is nothing but positivity right here. All right. I absolutely love this. Now, at first glance, someone would hear that and they would think, well, if you got nothing left to give, then, like, you're all out of gas. But that's not actually true when it comes to this, all right? Because you can think you have nothing left to give. That's when you have to reach down deep and keep powering through it, all right? It's a person that can see the bright side through the dark times when there ain't one. So when there's no bright side in sight at all, but he can still find something to be happy about. You know what I'm saying? He can still find something to keep going. All right. Oh, this is getting deep right here, y'all. It's with someone who ain't never had nothing, ain't afraid to walk away from more profit, because they'd rather do something that they really love and take the pay cut. It's a person that would never waver or change who they are just to try and gain some credibility, so they can feel accepted by a stranger. This is some powerful stuff right here. It's a person that can take failures in their life and turn them into motivation. It's believing in yourself when no one else does. It's amazing. Absolutely. You know what I'm saying? This right here is making me realize I've missed out on a lot. All right, I definitely need to start doing a lot more NF. All right. So that's coming. At this point, I may have only heard three or four songs from NF. All right. I haven't really paid attention to any of them as far as the lyrics go. I did a reaction to one of his songs a while back. I don't remember if I would do, I don't think I would do the lyrics on it. But I definitely should have if I didn't. All right. And going forward, any reactions I do, I will be going through the lyrics on his music. All right, 100%. I've done said things that I can't take back. Was a lost soul at a crossroad who had no hope, but I changed that. Absolutely, and that's what it's all about. You know what I'm saying? I spent years of my life holding on to things I never should have kept. Full of hatred, years of my life carrying a lot of baggage that I should have walked away from. This song is about life in general. All right. I'm loving it. Growing pains a necessary evil. Yeah, I mean, look, it's hard learning lessons the hard way, right? But the important takeaway there is that you've learned a lesson, all right? What we have to realize is that no one's perfect. And when you put people on pedestals and then try and dictate to them, "You're on this pedestal now, so don't let me down." That's not right. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're just asking to be let down at that point. The philosophy in here is incredible. Some would say having a mental breakdown is a negative thing, which on one hand I agree with. On the other hand, it is the push I needed to get help and to start the healing process. See, if I'd never hit rock bottom, would I be the person that I am today? I don't believe so. I'm a prime example of what happens when you choose not to accept defeat and face your demons. Took me 30 years to realize that if you want to get the opportunity to be the greatest version of yourself, sometimes you got to be someone you're not. To hear the voice of reason. So in the outro, he is saying, "Wake up every day, pick up my son, hold him in my arms, and let him know he is loved. Standing by the window, questioning if dad is ever going to show up, isn't something he's going to have to worry about. Don't get it twisted. That wasn't a shot. Mama, I forgive you." So I'm wondering what actually he's talking about here. I'm gonna go ahead and check the annotation because I think this is something personal. All right. In the music video for "How Could You Leave Us," Nathan is seen looking out a window. Who is Nathan? I'm wondering, is that his son? Nathan is seen looking out a window, waiting on his mom, who neglected him as a child and eventually died to a drug overdose. Now, I wonder, can I get some backstory on this, on these scenarios that we're talking about here? All right. This feels personal. This feels like things that he's actually experienced to one degree or another. All right. And the third line, NF makes clear that he is not harboring hatred towards his mom, but just pledging not to follow her example and the previous two lines. This is emphasized by the next line. Yeah, this is something that is really deep right here, y'all. All right. I don't think I should speak on it too much because I don't know exactly what happened. Okay. All right. You guys let me know though. Let me know exactly what happened. And then that way going forward, I'll have that information, right, to where I could more easily understand what he brings up and he's talking about these things that he's actually experienced, right? Or if these were things someone else experienced, right? And he's just adapting them and making it seem like these are his experiences. You guys let me know which one it is. But it really feels like these are personal to him, right? I just don't want him to grow up thinking that he'll never be enough. I mean, of course, like, you know, that's what every parent should want, right? You know, that just makes perfect sense right there. You know what I'm saying? So this last segment here, he's saying 30 years of fearful, empty, broken, hopeless, never, later, hollow, darkness, Nate. I don't know what the reference there is, if this is a person named Nate or what. You guys let me know. Baggage, sadness, stagnant, chains, anxious, suffering, torment, and weight. All negative things, except for Nate. I don't know what the context there is. All right. Years of bitter, 30 years of lonely, 30 years of pushing everyone away. You know, again, these are all horrible things. You'll never evolve. I know I can change. We are not enough. We are not the same. So here, he's either arguing with his inner demon or he's arguing with people who are trying to drag him down. You don't have the heart. You don't have the strength. You don't have the will. You don't have the faith. You'll never be loved. You know, these are all, you know, this is negative flooding, is what this is. This is, we're gonna try and hit him with everything we got so we can drag him down and keep him from being successful. All right. And it's like I said, this is a them problem. This is not a you problem. All right. Might as well give up, not running away. You don't have the guts. You're the one afraid. I'm the one in charge. I'm taking the no. I'm taking the reins. So yeah, this was a back and forth argument. So he's basically telling you guys how to respond to hate. All right. It is very simple. It is like I said it a few times already. It's a them problem, not a you problem. So he, the very last line, he says, "I'm taking the reins. Take control of your own journey." All right. Do not let people stand in your way and dictate to you what path you need to take. All right. If it is not your path, then don't take it. You know, don't let people try and get in your way and drag you down. All right. So amazing video right here, y'all. Absolutely loved it. I love the message behind it. Let me know what other songs from NF I should check out. All right, because I absolutely love this. You know, the atmosphere, the tension that he created, right, with the music and everything else. I mean, this was a masterpiece. An absolute amazing video, right? What I would say to everyone else who's, you know, just doing what everyone else is doing, I want to point you to this and show you that you can think outside the box, you can do things differently, and it can still work. You know what I'm saying? So, absolutely amazing video, NF. All right, absolutely loved it. All right, that's it for now, y'all.